If you are looking for a way to set up your project budgets, to help plan its initial costs and break down at a high level, then TPG's CoRePlanner is a solution that is able to deliver this. TPG's CoRePlanner provides quick and easy planning of work and costs, centralized file storage to assure data integrity, the ability to schedule cost resources or enter time-phase cost information for labor, material, and/or expenses, and if desired, the data can be exported to your project or financial systems, for example, SAP or Project Online, using TPG's PS Link. It's as easy as working with Excel, but with some additional benefits. In our presentation, we will demonstrate the creation of a new project and the different stages that will lead us to establishment of a budget by planning for work and the cost of resources over time. Let's begin by taking a quick look at the commands in the projects group within the general ribbon. New, for entering a new project. Reload, the existing and active scenarios are new. Edit mode, this must be enabled before any edits are possible. A project can only be edited if the project was in read mode when it was previously closed, or if it is open by the same user. Read mode, for viewing only, allows others with permissions to edit and make changes at the same time, save, and of course close the active project. These will be the features that will help us get started. Now, let's begin by entering a new project. To do so, we click on the new command in the projects group in the ribbon. We get a dialog box where we provide the name of our new project and perhaps some other custom fields if desired. We click OK to proceed. We are taken back to the home screen of CoRePlanner, but now we will see the name of the project file that we've just created displayed on the top left side of the two-sided window pane, which is just below the ribbon and to the right of the quick launch menus, which sit to the left side of it on our screen. We use the quick launch menus to navigate to CoRePlanner and to our other CoreSuite solutions like Portfolio Manager, Team Manager, etc. Note, we are in the task view. Here, our project data on the left side of the window pane is organized and grouped by tasks with a time phasing of work and costs on the right. There is also a resource button in the view group at the very left of the general ribbon that will display our project data grouped by resources. There is also the matrix button, which enables us to assign resources to tasks which we will see used after we build our team of resources by using the Build Team button that's found in the resource group of the same general ribbon. By clicking on the Add button, the resources are allocated to the project. Once the resources have been added, we'll be returned to the task space view. Next, we'll create tasks under our project summary row. This is the row that displays the name of our project. We need to select the summary row and use the new subtask button found in the task group of the general ribbon. This creates a new task whose name can now be edited. Task names can also be edited by double-clicking them. To add other tasks at the same work breakdown structure level, we can click instead on the new button also found in the task group. We can also add subtasks under selected tasks. This is the way to create a project structure with different levels of summarization within a project. Once tasks have been created, we can proceed to assigning resources to them, provided they were assigned to the project using the Build Team feature discussed earlier. To assign resources to tasks, click on Matrix, which can be found in the Views group. The screen opens up a matrix containing tasks and resources. Select the checkboxes for the desired assignments. Once the resource assignments are done within the matrix, we go back by clicking on the Tasks view icon. The project tasks and the corresponding resources are now seen indented under the respective tasks. The work and cost columns on the left side of the pane will summarize the data on the time phase rows on the right. The periods on the right can be set to months, quarters, or years using the timeline setting using the scope button in the timeline. The timeline can also be shifted by using the left and right arrows, also found in the timeline group of the general ribbon. Work values can be entered against assignments using the cells in the time phase portion of the screen. Using a monthly timeline, we'll go ahead and enter the number of hours in the work cell. Notice the cost calculation is automatically calculated given that the resources have a rate already within their profile. Note, for resources of type cost, such as in our hardware example, the cost will be entered directly in the corresponding cell. Work or costs can also be easily populated by using standard copy and paste functionality. Note, a red vertical line is visible in the time phase side of our view. This is our fiscal year separator, and it can be set within TPG's Core Admin features, which is found in the Quick Launch menu. Note as well that we can use the resource view to analyze and make edits in order to set forth our project budget structure. In essence, this represents what we can do with CoRePlanner. Isn't it easy? With regards to administration, it is also easy to add users and define their permissions, just as we do with our other Core Suite solutions. TPG's CoRePlanner can be used in a standard fashion. However, if desired, importing or exporting can be accomplished with TPG's robust PSLink middleware solution. That's it for this presentation on TPG's CoRePlanner. For more information, please visit our website and do not hesitate to contact us at theprojectgroup.com. Thank you for watching.